Now, Titleist have always been very good at making fairway woods, and certainly the 913s, the FDs were excellent clubs, particularly for driving from the tee. This time round, there's been big changes, and with the 915 fairways, first thing you're going to notice is there's a channel in the sole of the club. It looks a bit like a slot, but I'm told to tell you by Titleist this is not a slot. It's actually a bit longer than a slot, they say, because the channel actually goes right around the sides of the face. And what that is there to do is to increase the ball speed on the face, because it allows it just to flex a little bit more at impact. And that means on those low face hits, which you're going to get a lot with the fairway wood, you're going to get a little bit more ball speed and a little bit more forgiveness. Now, the active recoil channel, arc as it's known, then combines with the radial face on the club, which, unlike before, which is a variable face thickness, this is a standard thickness right across. It's just 2 millimeters thick, and that is there to help get the most out of the extra flex in the face that comes from using the arc. Now, Titleist have had two versions of their fairways. There's usually an F and there's an FD, and the FD is there for the lower spinning player, and I've kind of leaned towards those clubs because the head's just been a little bit bigger. I kind of prefer that size of fairway width head. I thought the Fs were always a little bit on the small side. So when I picked up the 915 FD, I went straight for it. I went, oh no, what have you done to my FD? Because the head's a lot smaller. But then I picked up the 915F, and you can see that the head is a lot bigger, and they've almost swapped the sizes of the head, with the FD really being there for better players. It's only down to two lofts. There's a 13.5 and a 15, and that is a very low spinning club, particularly if you're going to use it off the tee. I think it'd be perfect, although I'm still not quite sure why better players need a smaller head. I'm sure they want just as much forgiveness as the rest of us. Therefore, really, the club to really look at is the 915F, no matter what level of player you're on. It's great to see the head size a lot bigger, because I think that's going to suit an awful lot more players. What it also is going to give you is the fact that this still spins less than the old FD, so you are getting that benefit of all the good things that the FD brought you in that bigger head in the 915F. And certainly when I went to the fitting section with Titleist, I was able to show that my 915F at 13.5 degree was spinning 20% less. I was getting 2.8 miles per hour extra ball speed, and that was giving me an extra 12 yards. Now, the best thing about that was those are the results when I was hitting the ball from a tee. When I started hitting the ball from the turf, I was actually noticing very little drop off in performance, and that's because the arc is doing its job in terms of increasing the ball speed on those lower strikes and on those off-center hits as well. And even better still, I was actually longer by 5 yards with the 915F off the deck than I was with the 913FD off a tee. So what that means is if you liked the FD clubs before, then really you should be moving into the F. And if you didn't like the Fs before because they were too small, then you can move up to the Fs because they've got those bigger heads, but you still get the better performance that I think you would have had you been able to have an old F with a slightly larger head. The only downside, of course, hitting off the turf is that the grass does tend to clog up in this little channel here, but you know, if you get a little brush or if you get a pitch mark repair to go it through, then you will be able to clean that out no problems. When it sits at address, I thought it sat very well indeed. There's a new alignment aid for those who are very astute and that they spotted that the triangle has been reversed. It now goes left to right rather than right to left. And they've done a very good job with the paint finish. It's a very shiny club, but if you look quite closely, there's some in the right light, there's a very sort of sparkly finish to the paint job, which I think looks very classy indeed. There's extra loft in here. There's a 16.5 degree version, which brings the total options up to 5, which go from 13.5 degrees right up to 21 degrees. So there should be a club in there for everybody. And it's really a question of going down and getting fitted, because the clubs still come with the SureFit Tour hosel, which allows you to independently adjust loft and lie, which is still one of the best models out there in the market. And their version is very slim. It doesn't really stand out too much at address, so you know you've got a very sleek looking hosel, which is going to give you a multitude of options. There's also two new shafts with the fairways this year. There's the Ardila Rogue, and there's a couple of Diamana shafts as well, which between them are both quite firm shafts, I feel. There are other options, of course, as well, but it does suit this club very well. That's all for me today. So for more information about all Titleist products, please visit the website at golfalot.com.